Meet Da Crew Podcast. We are the change we desire to see in this world. If you won't change, you have to be the change. We are looking for 3 more hosts to join our team. If you have a message for the world and would like to be a part of the hottest new podcast and media network rocking the podcast world right now, join Da Crew Podcast and Media Network. Looking for a little exposure? Allow HTA Enterprises the opportunity to share your brand around the world. We will work with you to develop a package that fits your budget. Contact AEA via email and schedule a consultation. Da Crew Podcast 203@gmail.com. We are the change we desire to see.
Are you tired of the burden of past financial mistakes weighing you down? Look no further than BHG Credit Solutions, the industry leader in credit repair. We understand the challenges you face: charge-offs, late payments, bankruptcy, and those daunting student loans, but don't let them define your financial future. Here at BHG Credit Solutions, we've got your back. Our team of dedicated professionals specializes in turning credit adversity into opportunity. We'll work tirelessly to dispute inaccuracies, negotiate with creditors, and to develop personalized strategies tailored to your unique situation. Our proven track record speaks for itself. Countless satisfied clients have seen their credit scores soar.
Basic Black, After Dark, the all-new podcast show with your host, Black Diamond.
Hey everyone, this is Black Diamond from the Crew Network, and you're listening to Basic Black After Dark Podcast, the show that meets you where you are and gives you what you ask for. You know, for years, I've been weathering the storm, from being on the run after a hit was put on me and my family, to needing protection after witnessing a murder. Well, my guest tonight is no stranger to the other side of the storm. Please welcome visionary author Diana Hill.
Hi, good evening, everyone. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you doing?
I'm blessed. I can't complain. Getting ready for my book signing tomorrow.
Oh, wow. I know you're excited about that. Congratulations.
Yes.
Diana, question for you. You know, again, I thank you for being here and supporting the Crew Network and being
Thank you for having me. Thank you so much for having me.
When people hear a storm is brewing, they usually prepare for it. When people hear a storm is brewing, they stay in one location instead of evacuating. How did you prepare for your novel, The Other Side of the Storm?
So how I prepared for it is I was working on something else, and God told me that I had to put something together for women. And I was literally in the storm at the particular moment. I was in 2 storms. I was in a health storm, and I was in another storm. I'm not going to say too much. But during that storm, I always had God to lean on every which way.
Wow.
I really don't know how, no other way to put it, but it was the strength of the Lord that helped me through my storms of life that I just, that I went through.
Amen, amen, amen. So I'm glad that you're here. I'm glad that you're doing well. You created a guide, A Marriage, A Life's Journey, a 30-day devotional, The Everyday Woman, and an anthology, The Other Side of the Storm. What is your preferred style of writing? Is it Christian?
I am an inspirational writer. I realized that my passion is, I have a purpose towards women. It's really basically towards women. That's who I resonate with. That's who I identify with, is women that have a purpose in their life to reach out to women.
All right. There's nothing wrong with that. Okay. So that I guess that was part of you doing the book that you've done, The Other Side of the Storm. Do you believe your book, The Other Side of the Storm, will change people?
Yes, because the stories are so compelled that you won't have no other choice but to feel inspired in spite of going through your storm. Like the stories that's compiled by these women, how they triumph over tragedy, how they triumph over everything. This will give you courage, and this will give you encouragement on how to really make it to the other side of the storm with resilience.
Let me ask you, how do you stay strong and weather the storm?
I thank God. I have a circle that I can depend on, and I also have my wonderful husband of 17 years. He holds me down as well. But God is my source.
All right. I heard that. There are some things that you can learn in the storm. What are some of the things that you learn while writing the other side of the storm?
Patience and resilience. And it wasn't easy telling my stories that I have, because as I was writing it, I still was in a health crisis. But I knew that me continuing believing on Christ, that I was going to make it out of that storm.
Okay.
Well, and I did.
And I see. You seem to be just as healthy and happy and prosperous. Although the series was inspired and written by women, and what can men take away from this book?
They can take away the same thing. Listen, it's all about trusting in the Lord, having faith in the Lord, that mm-hmm. you will be able to see yourself out of any storms of life that come your way. It's all about having faith in yourself and having faith in the Lord. And also, surround yourself with positive people that will give you positive energy that will help you egg on in life. We had to still, because it takes a village. It takes a village to also find your purpose. You can't do it by yourself. And you can't get through the storm by yourself either.
It's true. That is definitely true. You dedicated this book to your husband of more than 17 years. He shared your testimony and he told you to take a chance on yourself. What did he mean when he said to take a chance on yourself?
So what happened was, before this was formed, right, I was on a discovery call to be in somebody else's podcast. And in the past, in somebody else's anthology. And I have been in several anthologies, including Angela's. And it was a Zoom call, and I had it on speaker because it was on a Sunday and I was cooking. So I listened to the discovery call and everything. Immediately after I hung up, when I went in my bedroom, my husband sat up and he said, "I need you to take a chance on you." He said, "You've been in everybody else's anthologies. Why don't you create your own anthology?" And from that moment, I said, wow, I wasn't even thinking about that, because I love being in other people's anthology. I never envisioned that I would be creating my own anthology, and it was birthed from there.
Well, for those who don't know, she mentioned that she was in Angela's anthology. Angela is the producer for the Crew Network.
I've been in several of her anthologies, at least three of them.
Okay. And they always say that there's always a good woman behind a man, but in this case, it seems like there is a good man behind this woman to give you that. Can you tell us something? What does taking a chance on yourself look like for you? Now, your husband told you to take a chance, but what does that look like for you?
Right now, we're in a space that I am. This anthology right here, from this book right here, I took my chance. I leaped and I literally took a chance on me, and it's seven other women that survived in this. And it was amazing. I laughed, I cried. I realized how putting an anthology together, some of the situations that came through, but I still made it on the other side of the storm, even creating this.
How long did it take from the time that your husband told you or suggested that you do your own anthology until you got everybody together? And, you know, what was it like finding the people to participate in the anthology?
Well, basically, because I didn't know how many people, but the people that I did ask and I talked about it, they all said yes without no hesitation. That it started in March of last year. But then in the midst of me trying to get everything together, I had a health crisis. So I had to put it down, and then it started back up sometime the last quarter of the year. I forgot what month. And then it was finally published in July.
What was it like for you when you saw it, that it was published and it was your anthology?
Oh my God, I just couldn't believe it. I just was like, wow, I really birthed this. And I could only give God the glory because it was Him that brought me through everything that I went through. I really birthed this baby. This is my baby right here. I don't care what other stuff that I'm involved with, but this is my baby. This is, God promised me this. He promised you do this. I'm going to bless you with this book. I'm going to bless this book and whatever else that comes for afterwards.
The cover of the book is amazing. I love the colors. I love the title. Let's start with the title. What made you choose that title?
Actually, my husband gave me that title. my bishop was doing a series on the other side of I quit. So I was writing everything I was writing, but I was still in a storm. And one day we was driving from church and he just dropped it. And he said, I got it. The other side of the storm. I said, oh my God, it makes sense because I literally am on the other side of the storm.
Wow, that is so amazing. The color, the cover, everything, it just pops. Can you show us a copy of the book? Now I see it, but I want everybody else to see it. This is amazing. Look at the colors in there. You can walk any place in a bookstore. You can see it sitting on somebody's table and it just pops. You know, I'm looking at the clouds and I'm looking at just everything. And we see
praising God in the storm. I was praising God in the storm.
Wow. Hey, Patrice. Hey, Latanya. Thank you so much for joining us. What can you tell us about this book that we won't see in a blurb or any other playhouse? What could you tell us about this book?
This book, it just will bless you. It just will bless you. It's so many stories that will resonate in your thought process on how to really make it outside the storm. Like, you just have to get the book. The words can't even describe on the faith that every last one of my co-authors had writing their stories while they was in the storm and how they came out the storm.
Patrice says, I am a cover person and that draws me in. Well, this book is going to do more than draw you in. It's just the colors for me. You know, I hear people saying, it's this for me, it's that for me. This book, it's the cover for me. And that's what had me say, I need to know more. I need to know more about this book. What is a significant way your book has changed you since you've been published?
It changed my thought processor to a higher level. I always know that I had to have a service, a product, and an event. And this is the service. I mean, this is the product of the situation.
Now, you mentioned your pastor. What are they thinking about this book?
He loved it. My pastor, Bishop Stephen Walker, he loved it.
Did they pray? Did they do something like a prayer before? Once you brought it in and presented it to them, that it was published and here it goes, you know, did they do something, you know, regarding that? Like, some people baptize a book, you know, once a person has
the
book.
He prayed over it and he signed. He was the first person that bought my book, actually.
Oh, wow. And how is that going?
It's magical. It's on the first day, when we didn't even have no copies, my book became a bestseller on Amazon in 4 different categories. The first day, it was number 3 in on Amazon of new authors, number 3.
Well, I know you wasn't surprised.
I really was surprised. I literally, when I told my co-authors, I just started crying because it's funny how neither one of my other books that I wrote became a bestseller, but this right here became a bestseller, and God strategically showed this to me. It had to be this way. 3 times the charm.
Well, you said that the one that told you, along with your husband, told you to write this book, and the title itself, The Other Side of the Storm. So, hey, you're storming all the way through. I'm sitting here talking to us.
And the funny thing is, right, last year my devotional came out. And when it came out, I didn't even really get a chance to market it like that. I sold my first batch, and then I had just purchased some more books to start selling. And the Holy Spirit told me to put that book down. Don't do no marketing. Don't do nothing. Don't even try to go in the bookstore, libraries, or none of that. Put that book down, and I want you to focus on the book for the women. Me being obedient unto the Holy Spirit, now here I am.
Wow. Patrice says she's loving the title also. She also, again, she loves the cover, but she loves the title as well. She's also one of my podcast sisters, and she reviews books. So you may want to skip over to there once we finish here to chat with her, because she's one of our best reviewers. So that's something that you may want to do. But I just couldn't help you to come on to talk to you about this wonderful book. Again, title, color, covers, watching you in action, reading about you, following you. It's just all about everything. It's like the whole package. He knew what he was doing when he asked you to write that. I don't think anybody else could have done The Other Side of the Storm. You see some titles close to it, but nothing like this. We're getting ready to take a break right now. And when we come back, we're going to continue with visionary author Diana Hill.
All right.
Right, you must be having a problem with that commercial that should be coming through. But we can keep going, and once the commercial comes up, then we'll just go for that break on the commercial, okay?
Okay, no problem.
It's the whole package. Like I said, it was just the whole package for me that just sold me. And I said, please let her say yes. Please let her say yes. You know, it's just amazing, you know, what he can do, what God can do.
God can do the impossible.
And he has.
Listen.
Does having the faith you speak about in your book mean the same as believing?
Yes.
How so?
Because you have to have faith. You have to believe in something to have faith. You have to believe in a higher power to have faith. Faith without works is dead. So you had to have faith in something.
That title sounds very familiar to me. Yeah, it does. It definitely has something here. A question that I have for you is, how has your faith affected your relationships? Or does faith affect your relationship at all?
Faith helps me in my relationships, especially in my marriage. Because I've been married going on 18 years, and we done been through some trials and tribulations, but it's only the Lord that brings us through my trials and tribulations and triumph in my marriage as well. And God is the center of my marriage, no matter what I go through. Let me tell you, Angela know a little bit about that. as well. When I was in the storm, when she had her 121-day praying, 5 o'clock in the morning, not this year, but last year in 2022, I barely missed any days. I was sick and going through whatever I was going through, but I was up 5 o'clock every morning. Sometimes she would call me to pray out loud, and my husband was right here, right along with me. And it was an amazing experience that I went through, and that strengthened me, and that helped me through writing my book as well.
Wow. So yeah, it does sound like you've definitely been through the storm.
Yeah,
I'm sorry?
No, yes.
You have several authors who wrote in this book. What challenges did you face, if any, with writing this book?
I could just say patience. I had to be patient with every single author. I had to be patient with all any kind of hiccups that may have came my way. But God gave me the strength to go through, to navigate through it all. Because you already know, when you're putting anything together, it was the journey for me. I really enjoyed the journey with these women. I just learned more patience in life. I just learned more patience because I'm short-tempered sometimes. But God said, nope, I'm going to give you patience. Nope, I'm going to give you patience. And they all had my back at several times when I thought I had my little meltdowns. They brought me from a 20 to a 10, from a 10 to a 5. And I made it through.
Okay.
And here we are.
Yeah. The Other Side of the Storm is a series of inspiring and unique stories from women who triumphantly overcame all obstacles. What else can we expect in the series?
You mean in the book? Or
yeah. Is there going to be a series of The Other Side of the Storm?
Yes, there's a part two. Stay tuned.
So since you're planning a part two, are you planning a part two to any of your other books?
I'm not sure. I'm focusing on this right now. God told me to focus on this.
Can you share a tiny bit about your plans for this one?
Okay, so I am actually doing a women's conference, God's willing, next fall. Okay. If not the end of 2024, the beginning of 2025. And it's going to be in a women's empowerment conference surrounding the book. And part two will be out too, as well.
So
I'm working on it. Right now. It's in the infancy stages, but I'm working on it right now.
So it sounds like from this book, and you're saying that you're doing an empowerment conference of women who have been through certain struggles, triumphs, tragedies. So that's more of who you're directing that conference towards?
Yes, ma'am.
I can't wait. Please keep me abreast of that conference. I'm definitely interested in that conference. It sounds like it's going to be something.
It's going to be right here in Philadelphia, PA.
All right. Well, I'm not too far from you, so I know how to get there. Was your 30-day devotional, The Everyday Woman, an inspiration for The Other Side of the Storm?
No. Actually, I didn't even have a clue that I was going to even be writing an anthology at that moment. When I wrote that book, I had COVID.
Oh,
I was sick with COVID. So that's part of my storm too. I got real sick with COVID. And once again, I don't know what it is about me and the Holy Spirit, but we've been having a two-way dialogue lately. And I was sitting down, and I had physical therapy. And at the time, I had only 75% of my left hand functioning because of the nerve damage that happened from me having COVID. To God be the glory, I'm still here to talk about it. And I'm sitting in my chair, and God said, you got to write a devotional for women.
Mm.
Mind you, I'm left-handed, and I'm sick in my body. But I was obedient unto the Lord, and that was birthed and that was published last January. And then this book right here was birthed in March. The inception of the book was birthed in March.
Oh, wow. Wow, unbelievable. The women in the book overcame obstacles similar, I guess, maybe to you. Everybody came over obstacles. Did they believe their faith pulled them through, or did they believe that this soon will pass? Because did you guys have
a little bit of both, a combination of both, a combination of both. Just like me, a combination of both. Just having faith to believe that this moment shall pass, and that they had encouragement to see better days in life.
Wow. And you said it was how many other authors in this book?
It's 8 of us all together.
Wow. Have you or will you be doing a book fair or a book signing with all the authors together? Or is everybody
tomorrow?
So everybody's going to be together tomorrow.
Yes, we all going to be together tomorrow.
And this is the first time that you guys are going to be together?
No, actually, this is going to be our second time that we all together.
What was it like during
the first time? But I know this is our second time that everybody collectively is going to be together. But I know each and every last one of them personally.
Oh, wow. That's special. It's like family. So everybody, you were definitely melted together to be able to do this and go on this journey together. So as you guys were going on this journey together, it was like no stone unturned.
It was like no stone
unturned. Which was just phenomenal that you already knew each other. It's not like you posted something out there and said, who wants to do an anthology? You knew them. It's almost like you guys were handpicked by the Lord to pull this together. And from what I'm seeing and what I'm hearing, you pulled it off.
And without them, it wouldn't be no anthology.
Wow. Wow. So praise them.
I may be the visionary, but they are the book as well.
Wow.
They are the book. Their stories are the book.
Is this the first for some of them?
This is the first of many of them.
Oh, wow. So I know
that. My one co-author, Laverne Cheeseborough, she have a book coming out. She have a book that's already published that just was published like 2 weeks ago.
Oh, wow. Congratulations.
And we was in another anthology together back in 2016 called our very first anthology together was called Wives on Fire. So that's how I actually became an author. I was the co-author of Wives on Fire in 2016.
Wow, so you have some books underneath your belt. Great. What are some of the messages you want to convey in this book to your readers?
My main message is just have hope in your storm. Just have hope while you are in your storm, and just know that there's always a rainbow after the storm. And this is only for a season. And whatever season that you are in, just know that there is a sun on the other side of that storm. After every storm, there's always the sun and there's always a rainbow.
Wow. Well said. Well said. Okay, Diana, enough about your book. I want to know more about you as a certified transformational purpose life coach, mother
yes.
of six.
Listen,
you have a ministry and you were nominated for I Am Her International for Women of Influence. Let's start off with your certified transformational purpose.
That came while I was in the storm as well. So understand.
Wow.
That came about in 2021, and I didn't even know how that was birthed. Don't ask me. It just was birthed. I put that down. I was doing that. I'm certified, but I never had my first client. I'm about to have my very first client from Kenya, and real soon. I don't know exactly when. But I'm going to have my first client from Kenya, Africa. real soon.
I think I'm going to have to change that title. Instead of it being Certified Transformation, it's going to be International.
Yes.
International in there, because that's exactly who you are. You're talking to somebody from Kenya, so that makes you international. I hope you know that.
Yes.
Now, you're a mother of six.
Yes, I'm a bonus mom of six and a bonus grandmom of 18. I seen half of my bonus grandbabies being born. I don't even call them up, even though I never birthed any of my children, but I helped my husband help navigate and raise his children. I seen half of my grandchildren being born.
You hear some people when they're in relationships or marriages and there's children that's brought into the marriage say bonus children, but I've never heard anybody say that they would say I helped raise them, but you said I helped navigate them. You helped your husband navigate, and I love that, you know, for you to say that you navigate, because yeah, it you have to navigate. There's different personalities, there's children coming into it, and children, babies born into the relationship. So how are they feeling about you being an author?
They love it. They love it. They're going to be there, at least a few of them, and a few of my grandchildren is going to be at the book signing tomorrow. I don't know who's all going to be there, but I do have that support.
I can imagine it's going to be a wonderful turnout. I know it's going to be a wonderful turnout. Tell me about your ministry.
I serve in the Lord. I serve in the house of the Lord. I am an usher. I'm on new members ministry. And I just love the Lord. I love serving people. That's my ministry. I just love serving people.
Now, you were nominated. Tell me about the nomination. I Am Her International for Women.
Somebody nominated me. I don't know how I got nominated, but somebody nominated me. Through Darashe Zorn. She have her ministry of I Am Her International. She's in charge of that. That's her platform. And I've been under her tremendous platform for years. Now I'm just cultivating. I'm being cultivated now. And actually my first coaching will be coming from her. She's in Kenya right about now. Oh, she's wow. A missionary, and she does a lot of stuff with the kingdom.
Well, Diana, you were chosen. You were chosen to do just this. You know, you've weathered the storm in many different ways, and he saw that, and he built that in you, and you just knew it was time to act. Is there any advice or ideas readers can take and apply from your book to their own life?
Just have faith in the Lord. That's basically all I could say. I can't really say too much. Just have faith in the Lord. Have faith in yourself. Take a chance on you for a change. Take a chance on you. Stop worrying about everybody else. Stop being on everybody, not saying not being on everybody else's platform, but take a chance on you. Write that book. Be that life coach.
Wow.
Write that song.
Wow.
Just take a chance on. Take a chance on you.
Well, you said it.
When you take a chance on you, you be surprised and believe that whatever you are trying to do, that it will come forth.
Amen. How can our viewers connect with you?
My viewers can connect with me. I'm on Facebook. I'm also on IG, 178 Diana Hill 1788. I can be reached at Diana Hill 6771@gmail.com. But I also have a couple of other things that's going on with me as well.
Well, tell me about it.
I have another anthology that's in the works right now. And it's going to be called The Precious Petals of God, because women is the precious petals of God. That's what 1 Peter chapter 3, 3, 4, and 5 tells us.
All right,
and that right there, you know how God said you turn 1 to 3 and 3 to 5? Well, this one is going to have 20 plus women.
Wow. The Crew podcast is saying, be the change you desire to see. Are any of the women that's in this anthology going to be joining you in the next anthology?
Majority of them are. Yeah, majority of them are.
Well, it sounds like you guys are staying in like a pack and y'all are just pushing these books out, pushing them out.
This is God. This is not even me. This is, I'm telling you, I just believe
that. For those who don't see, for those who don't believe, you're here. You're a visionary author. You're a life coach. You're a mom, a grandmom, and you're doing it. And he chose you. He took you through that COVID only for you to write these books and to pull these people together.
I'm also writing, in the process of writing my own autobiography, my life in Christ, from inception, from when I was in my mom's belly into where I'm at right now. So I'm doing a lot, and God keeps telling me to move, and it's crazy because this is all happening suddenly. This is all happening suddenly, all at one time.
So what else are you doing, or what have you not done?
And this is it right here. I don't have nothing else. I can actually say that I'm full. My plate is literally full right now for the next 18 months. My plate is full.
Wow. Congratulations. Congratulations. And Diana, I want to thank you for being a wonderful guest and sharing your journey with us. We truly hope that you enjoyed this episode with my guest.
Absolutely, I did. And I hope you had me again.
I will. You got the other book coming out. You got that conference that's coming. So you know I'm gonna be sticking with you.
Yes. Follow me. I follow y'all all the time. Tamala Lucas, Too Legit to Quit, Angela, Patrice Grimbell. Thank y'all so much. And you, thank you. Thank you for taking a chance on me, for even having me on your podcast.
No, thank you. Hopefully,
somehow, some way, I'll be connected to your podcast. Hopefully. I don't know. I'm hoping somehow, some way. So, yes, that
hey,
too.
We got space. We're always welcoming new people to come, strong people such as yourself to come, people like yourself who have a vision. Again, we have enjoyed this episode with our guest, visionary author Diana Hill. If you liked this episode, and I know you did, please leave us a review on the Crew Podcast Network and Facebook, and share this episode with your friends. Also, feel free to let us know what topics you'll like to see covered in future episodes by putting it in the comment section. Remember, no storm lasts forever. Join us September 1st, where my friend and literary coach, Dr. Jackie Gardner, will help you amplify your writing gift. After 8, after dark.
Thank you. Good night, everybody.
Night. Thank you.
Have mercy.